this is President Obama's second term. He doesn't have to worry too much about public opinion. He can really take some strong action.
He can.
But the problem is the House support. Is the House.
Got to get the House support, Republican House support.
Unemployment was a big issue during the elections. How does it look now?
Unemployment is a big issue, but it's come down to about within 8 to 8.5%. It used to be touched 10 at some point in time. I don't think it is, you know, being talked about as a much bigger issue now.
Argument 7.2 will korayum vannillengil President Obama jayikan sadhyamalla nu vare pravichichirunnavarundallo.
Yeah, but then a lot of things happened in the world, saying that they saw the unemployment going up in other countries like Europe, etc., across the border. Much higher percentage. You know, they realized that.
So that's not a big issue.
I don't think it's a big issue at the moment. The big issue now, there are two issues. One is management of the fiscal cliff, making sure that a bipartisan agreement is reached, you know, before the end of the year, which is today, at least in the next 1 week or so, to see that some kind of agreement is reached for the purpose of increasing the tax rates on certain segments of the taxpayers.
Right.
And also giving to Republicans on some spending cuts over a period of certain years to find about, you know, we're talking about a $2 trillion savings over the next 5 years. And there's a target to be reached within 10 years too. I think it is definitely reachable. There's an agreement. At the moment, it's not. There's an agreement, both parties agree that, yes, we've got to come to that level. The dispute is in the process.
So, fiscal cliff means they are climbing it, and if they don't reach the summit, they might fall off. Is that
exactly
it?
You know, okay. Just like, you know, when you say, you know, the Kovala business report is on a cliff.
Yeah, right.
A Kovala cliff, you know.
Right. So, you have to be on the top in order to be stable.
Exactly. If I go there in the first floor, and if I don't really hold on to something, I'm going to fall.
Okay, that's why it's called the fiscal
cliff.
You know, because you read about it in the papers, and one wonders what it is all about.
Yeah.
Coming back to the pre-election situation with the Sandy storm, etc., how far has it affected the economy in the East Coast?
You know, being a person who was seriously
East Coast.
affected by that.
You were affected.
And
how many days did you not have electricity?
I didn't have electricity for 13 days.
Oh, my God.
The longest ever. 13 days of complete darkness. See, darkness, etc., we can manage these days because they break. They make, you know, the torch and lights, and I can put in a torch in my pocket and walk around the house, and I can see light, you know, for about another 100 meters.
Right.
So that's not the issue. The issue was living in the house was bitterly cold, 0 degrees. No way you couldn't sleep or during the day, etc. So fortunately,
you are dependent on so many machines for your life.
Exactly. So the machines, yeah, it was. We had to move out. But the worst natural disaster the East Coast had, you know, in a number of years in my living memory. But what I admire is the manner in which the resources are mobilized well in advance of the hurricane coming through, which is called the Emergency Preparedness Program.
Right.
You know, moving about 100,000 of the people from the areas which are most likely to be affected by these flooding, etc., in Long Island, New Jersey.
You had no flooding in your area?
No, not in my area, but a lot of area living in that, near the Atlantic City and Long Island coast, etc. You know, they had to be moved out to schools and hospitals, etc. And we're talking about, you know, 300,000 people
being moved.
No, without 300,000 homes without power. Now, between New Jersey, Connecticut, and New York.
Right.
And they had to do one by one or week by week. You know, it took 13
days.
Trees
had fallen on the lines and so on.
The trees had fallen. See, in the suburbs still, all the wires are on poles, like the old system, not underground, like in the cities today. When they're building cities, you know, they're modernizing one by one, you know, when the wires are under the ground. But when these poles, in the brief, they fall down.
Right.
It's got to be manually put up again, you know, one by one. This took time. And a lot of trees were uprooted because the storm and the wind was about 85 to 90 miles an hour.
Right.
You know, when I got up in the morning and looked through my window, I could see, you know, the trees literally were dancing. And when I got up in the morning and came down, there were two big trees from a neighbor's house already fallen, escaping my roof just by 6 inches.
I see.
Otherwise, they could have damaged my roof too. It was so bad, you know.
But how was this managed, the hurricane? What was the technique used in order to handle it?
Well, the technique used in order to handle was it was taken as a national issue as opposed to a East Coast issue.
Mm-hmm.
With that in mind, I think complete attention was given to mobilization of resources to manage
mm-hmm.
and overcome the problem.
And that is how it helped him in the election.
That's how, it might have helped him in the election, but I think even otherwise, in my view, he would have won.
Yeah, right.
Whether it would have helped him in the elections, and maybe he would have got a few more votes, but he would have definitely won.
Right. And even the Republican governor complimented him. And
the Republican Governor Christie, who is a strong Republican, and he was not an admirer of Obama in the past, before the Hurricane Sandy storm, even he complimented and thanked him a lot, etc., which is an indirect endorsement of a Democratic person for election as an ordinary man sees it on TV.
And for
but
the long
hats
term.
Off, mm-hmm. hats off the way in which the mayor of New York, the governor of New Jersey, the governor of New York State, and the representatives from Federal Emergency Management Association worked to overcome this problem. To be truly an example, there were 30 million gallons of water in the Queens Midtown Tunnel, with which you are familiar. Bridge between
it drives through it every
New
day.
York City and Long Island.
Right.
No, they had to send army planes to come back and pump out this water in 2-3 days. That's why Bloomberg had to implement a rule saying that nobody can come to New York for a few days. We couldn't go to New York unless they introduced this emergency, this high occupancy vehicle. There got to be 4 people in the car between these hours, etc. So we couldn't. No, it is mobilized.
In any case, many people did not want to move around at that time. There were other problems also. No,
they wanted to move around. The sense was New York City was not that badly affected.
Right.
See, all the wires in New York City is under the ground.
Yes,
proper
exactly.
City. For example, my daughter who lives in Central Park South, she lost the power only for 2 hours.
My son didn't lose even for 1 hour.
Exactly. So she lost only for about 2 hours. Right. See, we want to drive and have dinner with her every day and come back, etc. So we couldn't at least kill a few hours in just staying at home. So we couldn't do that.
Which area will it be? Defense? Will it be finance?
I think it'll be foreign policy, in my view, predominantly. Right. You have been expert in that subject. But it's always, U.S. legislators will always be looking at, how is India voting on a U.S. initiative with Iran, for example. Those kind of issues are going to be predominant, for the strengthening and cementing the partnership between.
Whereas
India, India is India. Look, we are a developing country within India.
Yeah.
How we develop within our constraint, the foreign policy is more important than the strategic partnership. That's also a view on the Indian side.
Exactly. Particularly about our internal economic situation.
Particularly our internal economic question.
Yeah, but in 2013, to project for the future, I think the program is about to end. What would be your prognosis for the world in general, United States, India? You are an optimist.
Things are moving
better. Things are getting better economically. And the relationship and America's position.
Things overall, the worldwide things to get better economically, that depends on Europe. Can Europe come out of the recession?
Right.
But not on the cards for 2013.
So, U.S. is not the crucial element here.
U.S. is not the crucial element. In my view, Europe is the most crucial element here. Can they come out of recession 2013?
And you remain uncertain about that?
I remain very uncertain about the outlook for U.S. in 2000. Sorry, Europe.
In
2013, I think they are going to beginning to even achieve a moderate growth of 1%, 1.5% only beginning in 2014, 2015.
I see.
So until that happens, it's difficult to project,
an uncertain
going rate for the world.
I see. Well, thank you very much, Sridhar.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Joining
us. പൊതുവെ അമേരിക്കൻ സാമ്പത്തിക രംഗം മെച്ചപ്പെടുന്നുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ പോലും യൂറോപ്പിലെ സ്ഥിതിവിശേഷം മെച്ചപ്പെടുകയില്ലെങ്കിൽ ലോകത്തെ സാമ്പത്തിക സ്ഥിതി തുടർന്നുകൊണ്ടും മോശമായിരിക്കുമെന്നാണ് അദ്ദേഹത്തിൻ്റെ അഭിപ്രായം. ഈ വിദേശ വിചാരം ഇവിടെ പൂർണ്ണമാവുകയാണ്. മറ്റൊരു ലക്കവുമായി നമുക്ക് വീണ്ടും കാണാം അടുത്തയാഴ്ച ഇതേ സമയം ഇതേ ചാനൽ. നമസ്കാരം.